Hello, welcome to the self-learning podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Let us start discussion on Unit 15, Media and Public Policy. Democracy and media are two major elements in the process of development. As development is no longer viewed as the sole responsibility of the elected governments. In spite of the policy initiatives, the governments need people's participation in the development, and the various democratic processes like elections, movements and public debates help in securing it. The media, including the news media too, provides a forum for public debate on the issues of development apart from providing information regarding such issues. In this era of globalization, the media has emerged as one of the most powerful components of social management. The role of mass media in shaping the public opinion is well known. However, some communication experts and social scientists think that the opinion leaders have more significant role in shaping the public opinion. But from the days of capitalist revolution, the press was accorded the status of the fourth estate for no other reason than its power to influence the minds and thus accelerate the political process in favor of bourgeois democracy. In this unit, we shall understand the role of media in the policy making in general and public policy in particular. The role of media is twofold. On the one hand, the media influences the policy makers by putting forth the opinions expressed by various groups, including educationists, journalists and experts, leaders of different political parties, religious leaders, workers and peasant unions, etc. On the other hand, media pressurizes the policy makers or the authorities to act in response to the people's interests and demands by opening a debate and educate the masses. We shall now discuss impact of globalization and technological advancement on the process of democratization as well as on media and social development. We shall also examine the role of media technologies in advancing the process of democratization. Now let us discuss what is public policy. Public policy is a process that allows the national government, state governments, municipalities and panchayats to implement certain measures that would be in public interest. The matters regarding the health, social welfare, media, defense, agriculture, etc. are considered as issues affecting the masses and are said to be matters of public policy. Now first let us define what is public policy. A definition of public policy could be the one given by the Considine, who says public policy is an action which employs governmental authority to commit resources in support of a preferred value. Policy making, according to him, includes the clarification of public values, commitment of money and services, and granting of rights and entitlements. According to the scholar, public policy is where the community is trying to decide something as a community. However, another scholar feels that public policies are government decisions and actions to resolve public problems. He also defines public policy by saying, public policy is the result of struggle over the definition of the good society and the best ways to make it happen. Yet another definition of public policy could be the one that sees public policy as a strategy for achieving public goals through the management and allocation of power, rights, resources, information, and inducements. As we have seen, the domain of public policy is very large, and it includes anything under the sun that concerns people, be it a matter of hygiene or be it a matter of potable drinking water. There is always a need to identify a policy and then execute it in such a way that people feel good. Now let us move to the point, public policy and governance. In democracies, public elect their leaders at various levels based on the latter's capabilities of providing good governance. If the leaders belonging to a particular political party that forms the government do not make policies on matters affecting the masses, they are rejected by people. It is important for political parties who rule and those who sit in the opposition benches to have a certain perspective and stand on major issues concerning public policy. In a way, one can say that public policy making, debating over the existing policies and projecting a different viewpoint about public policy becomes an integral part of democracy and democratic governance. In democratic forms of government, the major part of the public policies are made in the parliament through legislative processes. Democracies have many layers of policy making institutions like state level and local governing bodies. Parliament is the supreme symbol of people's participation, where people elect their representatives. These representatives then discuss and debate all policy initiatives of the government before they are legislated upon. The political parties are another form of people's representation. People with similar political interests and views form a political party that reflects the ideology of a section of people. Workers and peasant movements, civil society like NGOs and social movements are also forums of political expression. Media is yet another institution that facilitates the communication between the government and the people. Now let us wind up the session and take rest. Thank you very much for engaging yourself with the self-learning podcast.